The project, whose main source of water will be Lake Bunyonyi, was launched by Aisha Sekendi, the State Minister for Water and Environment, over the weekend at Rwanda Town Council headquarters.
For God and my country.
The sub-counties in Rwanda District, which are going to benefit, include Ikumba, Hamura, Muko, Bufundi, Ruhija, Bubare and Bukimbiri sub-county in Kisoro District, whereas town council include Rwanda, Katojo, Hamura, Bubare, Hamuhambo, Kashasha, Mujera, Kacherere and Nyanamoni Town Council in Kisoro District. According to leaders, this will enable residents access clean water.
The project has come to restore people. I believe that the accessibility of safe water will increase up to 80 to 90%, given the distribution which they have presented us.
Like in my area, five villages of Rugarama, Mparo, Kasheche, Chigarama and Rurejero depend on one water well as their only source of water, which sometimes gets dry, especially in the dry season. We hope that after completion of this project, it will be a great relief to us. The water sources we have are currently far. Our children reach at school late because they have to first fetch water before going to school. Engineer John Twinomujuni, the commissioner in charge of urban water and sanitation in the Ministry of Water and Environment, said the implemented project is a presidential pledge.
My project is a project we are implementing following the presidential directive, the pledge he made to the people of Rwanda district and neighboring district also of Kisoro. Rwanda is one of the most water-stressed areas in the country. People travel, as you saw in the report, they move more than 1, 2, 3 kilometers looking for water, and the water they are looking for is not good, it's not clean at all. And despite that, you see the terrain is not conducive. So this encroaches on the value of time they would have otherwise used for production.
We have launched the design, and we are going to approach the Ministry of Finance. We have already started approaching the Ministry of Finance for funding of this project. Already also the French, through the French Treasury, have approached the Ministry of Water and Environment to provide funding for implementation of this project. Now that we have launched the design, after Ministry of Finance has approved funding, hope that we shall be able to start construction, not this financial year, but hopefully next financial year.
Aisha Sekendi, the State Minister for Water and Environment, who was the chief guest, warned politicians against inciting the public to demand compensation for their land where the water pipes will pass.
Okay, so I kind of a politician who's going to incite the community that they have compensated you before. Just tell us, Ugandans are eagerly waiting for such projects, we take it to another place. The government is not including compensation for where our trenches are going to pass. We have money to bring the service when you are ready to give us also where this project should pass.
The water project is set to kick off in the next financial year, and the contractual period is 3 years, projected to serve a total population of 500,000 people in the next 20 years. The ministry later signed a memorandum of understanding with the local leadership to ease implementation of the project. Report filed by Adolf Ayoreka for the News in Rwanda District.